Steve Comalander, Lake Monticello on a breezy morning. Starting to be breezy, storm's coming in. It's on a Wednesday. And nobody here but me today because storms are coming. People don't come on bad weather, but the old fisherman does. And I think we own a few white perch. We just had a little prior video, short one. And we're gonna throw back out here and see if we can catch some more of these white perch. I know the wind's gonna be coming through that speaker, but hey, we're gonna deal with it. We're gonna try to catch some more of these elusive white perch on Lake Monticello. Caught a catfish a while ago and I went to pick him up. He broke my lines. I had to tie my line, so. And it run my time down to about 18 or 20 minutes, so I thought I'd start a new video here. Caught a few perch already. See if they stay with us. Ought to be a good day with the storms coming in, if we can get them before it gets too bad. It's too windy where we can't fish. Wind's coming out the south, out the southwest. So it's blowing down the lake. Blowing down the lake today. Getting bites. There's a few down there. We'll get one on in a minute. Bound to hit it. A few of them stirring. I said the water's high this morning. I suspect it might feed today a little bit before this storm. Let's hope we have a banner day. One of them bonanza days with them magnum perch is what I want. Magnum perch. Hey, you. Come on, big white perch. Come on, boy. Come on, give me a nudding on that. It's cloudy today, so they really can't skylight it that good. It might not catch but one at a time. I don't know. Oh, we got two right there, but one of them's little. Got two right there. One of them's a throwback. Loney's not with us this morning. He's in there catching his own food, I guess. He went to work on his own today, which is good. So I can throw a few fish back today. I ain't got to worry about Loney taking them. Hopefully. Today we on top of the hump. High water, cloudy conditions. I started at 40 in the 40s today. Where I've been catching them in the 60s because it's been sunshiny. But today I think high water, cloudy conditions, they're gonna move up here. What I call shallow is still 48 foot deep. So shallow for me. It ain't really shallow. Shallow for me. And I'm thinking this lake in the 40s is about as shallow before they spawn out as you need to be fishing. After that, you need to go deeper. That's what I think. A lot of people don't never fish deep enough to catch these perch. They're in there too shallow in this lake. Lake Murray's a different lake now. Sometimes in Lake Murray, they'll get real deep in clear water and shallower up the river and when the water's dingier. So, of course, up the river, you don't have this deeper water. So they got to be shallow. Every lake has got different sections that's different. You just got to get the section that you like, the depth you like to fish, and fish that section of the lake where they holding in that depth. That's what you got to do. Now these fish, I see them coming through, but they're not really eating it up. I'm getting a few bumps, but I see a lot of fish in droves of them coming through. So they're stirring around this morning. We can get on the right bass, catch some of these jumbos. But I'm going to have to call them in to keep them on us today, though. They roaming what they're doing. They're just roaming. If you can have an underwater picture of that, you probably see just schools of fish just roaming. That's what I think. Some of them, you might see some on the bed, and you got some of them roaming, hunting beds. See, today, you never know, they might hit that daggone crappy jig the best. Yesterday I tried the crappy jig and they really let me down. I wasn't catching there. In fact, I don't think I ever caught a fish on Mr. Crappy. I caught him on the spoon. So I had to get rid of Mr. Crappy. I had to put this gut shrimp back out there yesterday to catch a fish. Fish are funny. Sometimes they won't even hit worms and metal, and they'll hit this gut trap. So you never know. There's a small one. 90% of them back. All I'd keep would be a couple nice ones, but there's no need to throw them back. Loney's going to eat them. So I take them home, clean them up, and most of the time I got somebody, I'll come over and get some. So a lot of work cleaning, though. I don't mind. I don't mind hard work. I'm a hard-working fella. Hey, oh Lord, that's a pretty nice fish right there. I don't know what he is. Might be a big perch. Started off nice, man, but I got a little left. I don't know. I believe that's a big perch. It is. A big old Monticello Jumbo Delight right there, buddy. Whoa, what a perch. That is a Jumbo Delight. I'll let this down, show you this fish. My goodness. Look at that water perch. Huh? That, my friend, is a jumbo white perch. I'm telling you. Look at that. Look how big that white perch is. Great day. I promise you that's over a pound and a half. My goodness. Oh my. What a white perch. Great day. Jumbo delight. That's what it is. You got your magnums, you got your whoppers, and you got your jumbo delight. That was a jumbo delight. I'm gonna start grading them in big, how big they are. Hey, they what a perch. Man, he creamed it too. He creamed it. He wanted that gulp shrimp. Jumbo delight. About to get some more of them jumbo delights. Hey, dang. Man, I thought I had a large mouth there for a second. Every fish has got its own little way of when you hook them, how they pull you. A good fisherman can tell what he's got on 90% of the time. Sometimes they'll fool you. But 90% of the time, I can tell you whether I got a large mouth or a catfish or a perch or a crappie. All that, they pull them different. Every one of them got their own unique style of pulling. But all of them, I like all of them the way they pull, let me tell you. A tug on this rod is what I desire. I'll tell you that right now. That old wind's starting to blow. It's going to be a rough day about this afternoon. If I catch any fish, I'm going to have to do it early. But I guarantee it's going to blow me off the lake today. Guaranteed to blow you off the lake today. They really ain't, of course, I think it's probably because of this cloudy weather. They ain't grouping up on them. They coming through. I'm catching a few, but I'm not really tearing them up. It's enough to keep you interested. Typical fishing right here. And I think it's because of the cloudy weather. They can't skylight these plugs that good. I've said it before. I think the better fishing, if you can get on them and get them stirred up, is on a clear day, deep water. Now this is kind of days here, if you're bass fishing or shallow bank fishing, they ought to be biting. A lot of your bass on a cloudy day, low light condition, crappies, they're going to come to the bank. Especially when it's high water condition, when the water's up and down like this lake every day. They'll definitely miss one. They'll definitely go to the bank. Now these perch ain't gonna go to the bank. They gonna stay out here deep. The other fish will go to shallow. These perch, I think, are deep water fish. Now that's a nice. Look at that one. White gulp shrimp. That's a nice. Nothing wrong with them. We'll take them kind of all day long. That's a pound perch. Pound perch is good. That's one step below a magnum. You get a pound and a quarter, that's a magnum. And then when you get over a pound and a half, that's a jumbo delight. Oh, and the wind is blowing and gonna blow today and tonight, what I hear. Probably gonna start raining here after a while. I didn't even bring a rain suit out here with me. I wasn't even thinking about that. It's getting awful cloudy. If I had to cut the show quick today. All right, Mr. White Perch, where you at? It's sure is nice not to have anybody out here. I got one fella that comes out here with me all the time, and he likes to creep up on me. I can't focus on what I'm saying in my shows when he's right beside me. It makes it tough on me. But anyhow, we'll get through it. I done pull, and I'll do that a lot of time with the wind blowing and not focusing. I'll pull myself off of where I need to be. So far this morning, they've been right on the tip top of this hump. I've been catching them out there another 100 yards off the tip, off the end of them, is where I've been catching them. So today, some of these fish has moved up a little shallow, and they could be, it's a shallow hump back in there. They could be any of them shallow humps today. Because it's cloudy and because it's wind blowing and high water. You got three things causing that. But I can tell you this, they close to the bottom today. Last a couple of fishing trips, they'll come up off the bottom because it's sunshiny. But when it gets cloudy, they don't seem to come up off the bottom like they do. There you. When it's sunshiny, that's a small fish. Not a big one, a little throwback. Boy, you lucky loading in around. You get to go back to the bottom. Get on back out of the way. All right. I see a couple of hooks right there on the bottom. They scattered all around here. We're 49 foot of water now. We're moving back on the hook. Getting on top of it. 49 foot. But you can see how cloudy and gloomy it looks. I mean, it's a really cloudy day. It looks like it could rain any minute. Any minute, I believe we could have some rain. I think it's going to be a steady bite, but a slow bite until some sun comes through where they can skylight these plugs and I can really tear them up. Catch two and three at a time, but it might not happen today. Might just have to struggle all day. They've been slowing up. These fish have been slowing up. And I'm sure some of them definitely been bedded. So you got staggered, you got some that hadn't bedded, you got some that's done bedded, you got some that might be a month off. I don't know. I'm just assuming things and saying what I believe. No way to really know for sure what these fish are doing, but when I cleaned fish yesterday, in fact, in my video yesterday, I caught some down the other end of the lake, and I assumed that they were spawning out down there, but when I got home, lo and behold, the daggum fish that I thought was spawned out, the big nice one, hadn't really even started its eggs yet, so I do a lot of assuming and contradicting myself the next trip. When I got home, those fish had not laid anywhere. I mean, all these fish had eggs in them, and that one I thought was thin and postponed was not postponed. So I got to regroup on that one. After I cleaned them, I could really see that the eggs hadn't even developed good in them yet, and that was toward the hotter water. So a lot of times, y'all hear me say things that I believe at the time ain't really fact. It don't seem like it. I hate to say that. But that's anybody out here trying to figure out these fish and trying to guess what's happening. And I'm thinking out loud to this camera a lot of times, saying what I believe at the moment, and then it might not be the exact truth. So, but I assume that they were boning out some of them. That one I just showed you with the eggs coming out, definitely. It's getting close, unless the pressure of me pulling them up off the bottom caused them eggs to come out. So we might have another month of these perch bite. Who knows? And they like this even earlier. You come out here some days, the weather's beautiful. Can't catch a fish. And it's like they're gone. You can't find them. Even me, with all the places I know to fish, and my talents are catching fish. Some days I'll come out here and might not even catch my 10 or 12 fish. So don't think it's like this all the time, because it ain't. So you people come out here, see my videos, y'all expecting to come out here and just drop down and catch a fish. It might happen, it might not. So don't get mad at me if you come over here not able to catch fish like I'm catching, because it's not just as easy as it look that I make it look at times. And anybody that fishes knows that I have fished this lake ever since it's been here. And I have fished all my life, so I would think that I'm pretty talented when it comes to finding fish. Would hope it. Sometimes I don't think I am. But most of the time, probably got 90% of the time I can find some fish. And that 10% of the time is always there. 10% of the time, I don't care who you are, you're not going to find fish. Now that's a nice white perch. But even when I got it back in the 70s in Lake Murray. I couldn't guarantee fish every time, and that puts pressure on a guide. Several times you go out and you don't catch them, you know, I don't charge them, I give them the money back. And that's the reason I don't like guide fishing, because it's that days that you can't find them, and it puts pressure on you. So I don't like to be a guide. I mean, I would be a good guide, but I still don't like, when I take somebody out to catch fish, I want them to catch them every time. And there's no way that you can guarantee 100% catch every time. I don't care who you are. Now, if you get on fish and go every day, your odds are really good that you're going to catch fish every time. But it's going to be them days that you can't catch fish every time you take somebody out. Especially taking people out that's not familiar with fishing. And that's the part I didn't like. And then you want them to catch them. You can't catch them and have them rod. And some people just can't fish. And they're paying you to try to teach them. And they want instant results. And that's hard to do. Now, let me tell you, on somebody that can't fish, there's people out there that don't even know when to get a bite, or how to stay in contact with the line. All that stuff's important. And you absolutely don't know how to fish. The best thing you can do if you're coming out here, you're going to bring somebody out here that don't know how to fish. I would say, if you throw out an anchor at 60 foot, let a little rope back, and just put a minnow down or a worm down at the bottom and reel up about three turns and let it set in a rod holder. And you see, on a soft tip, got to use a soft tip rod now if you're going to do that. Because them perch, let me tell you, if you don't have a soft tip rod, when they hit a live bait, they'll hit that thing, they feel a little pressure, and they'll let it go a lot of times. If they're not hungry, they'll let it go. Now, if they feed, they'll bite it. But you want a soft tip. What I mean a soft tip is you can bend the end of that tip. The lighter the tip, the better for crappies, minnow fishing, and perch. Where they can pull down, and that tip almost is so soft, it acts like a cart pulling the water with no resistance to the fish. If that fish has got resistance, and he'll let it go. A perch will let it go. He'll know something's wrong with it. So you got to have a soft tip rod if you're going to live bait fish. A whole different setup than what I'm using here. And preferably a spinning rod. You know, for live bait, I like spinning rods. I like the casting rod doing this because I just push the button and let it down. And if I catch a big, big fish, I can pull them on in a little bit better. But preferably, if I'm not casting for bass with a top water plug or anything like that, I use spinning rod. I use spinning rod for a worm fishing for bass, and not a kind of a stiff spinning rod for bass. But I only use 8-pound test worm fishing in Lake Murray because it's clear water. I'm a light line fisherman. I don't like heavy stuff. The lakes I fish, I don't need heavy stuff, and they all clear water. So I go light line. I use as low as 4. If I'm fishing for crappies, I use 4-pound test a lot. But you got to have a good reel. If you're going to use 4-pound test line, you got to have a good reel that's got a good drag to be able to have it real soft. And you got to work the fish in. When I say work the fish in, you got to pull up like this, keep tension on the fish and reel down, and then pull up again. You can't just sit there with a spinning reel turning the handle while the fish is pulling the drag, because that flips your line. And then you come back with a bunch of corkscrews in your spinning reel. So it's really important when you catch fish on a spinning rod reel, and when you pull it in, you pull up tight, then you reel down. Keep tension, but reel down when the drag's not pulling, and then pull up again, reel down when the drag's not pulling. Don't reel, turn that handle while the drag is making is squealing, because it's messing your line up. Just some tips I want to tell you folks that don't know a lot about fishing. So if you bring somebody out here fishing with live bait with a spinning rod, and if it's a lady, most ladies do, they just winding, it's pulling drag. Well, that'll mess your line up. So teach her to pull up, but keep tension on that fish. If you give him slack, he'll get off. So keep tension on the fish and reel down and keep pumping that fish. I call it pumping the fish in. That's very important with any kind of big fish. Just don't sit there and reel and reel and reel while the fish is pulling. Work the fish in, per se. And that's key. Enough about that. I'll give you a few tips, though. I have people calling in wanting me to tell them different things. I'll write it in, excuse me. Tell them different things, and that's just one of the things I thought you needed to know. Well, what happened? Let's see. I was talking. Guess what? I got off the tip of the hook. Now, I see gulls in that cove, and I've told you folks. Excuse me. If you got gulls surfing and diving, fish on all right, Perch. I'm going to get back with you when I get on some more. I got a cough here. Steve Comalander, Lake Monticello.